What's going on, guys? Garrett here, and today we're doing Squadcast episode 55 with Mr. Bosch the Win.
Hello.
And the Saints fan.
What up?
The Squadcast is our weekly podcast we do every single Saturday, where we talk about everything and anything dealing with GTA 5 and GTA Online. And this week's topics include mods in GTA 5, private servers might be coming soon, on top of that, the social club being hacked, and brand new information in regards to Black Ops 3 being leaked. Now, before we do jump into this Squadcast, we want to let you guys know about the giveaway we held last week. Now, there was some confusion on our end. We forgot to let you guys know to go to the Facebook page down below, facebook.com/utechsmart, to enter. So all you guys got to do to get a free mouse, if you guys missed last week's, go ahead and go to the Facebook page down below. It's at the top of the description. Go click it. Leave a comment on the Facebook page saying, like, I want a mouse. I want the Venus mouse. I want a Mies. Whatever you want in the comment, let them know that you want to win a mouse. And they're going to choose 5 people to win a mouse. So go ahead, go like their Facebook page, go comment. And with that, anything you want to mention, Ross or Austin?
Yeah, I've seen the mouse. They are absolutely incredible. There's a lot of different features that you can add and change to it. And it's really simple. All you got to do is go to their Facebook page and then leave a comment. Like, if I wanted to win a free mouse, that's like the easiest thing in the world. So go do it.
Maybe, I mean, like, you could probably, like, leave a comment saying why you think you deserve the mouse. Like, why do you think they should give you the mouse? Yeah, actually, do that. Make it, like, a little, like, a story. Like, why do you think you deserve the mouse over somebody else? Or maybe just, like, I want a mouse because I'm playing GTA 5 PC. And, yeah, that could be a reason, too. But without further ado, let's jump right into the first topic of this week's Squadcast, which includes GTA 5 mods and private servers that might be coming very soon, on top of that with the mods that just recently released. Austin, since you and I have the most experience about mods, Ross isn't a big fan of the mods just yet, but let's go ahead and talk about these mods. So as you guys know, we covered the past few days the GTA 5 trainer that recently came out. But Austin, you go ahead and let people know, because you have that whole mod showcase, or what is it called, mod workshop series?
The mod shop.
The mod shop. So lame.
Uh-huh. So, yeah, I mean, so far, like, as we stated last week, like, it's just going to get progressively better, the modding scene, I guess. And there's actually, this is sort of a side note, and we might can touch on this, but there was actually some drama in the gaming community about modding and Steam and Skyrim. But anyway, getting back to GTA, basically, yeah, there was this really popular mod from GTA 4 called it's the Native Trainer, and it allows you to do pretty much anything you want. Like, you can play as a whale. You can, you know, turn the weather and all that stuff on. Like, it's really cool. And actually, what's awesome about this version by, I think, Alexander Blade, he's the guy who made it, it actually, like, automatically disables once you go into online. So for people, you know, wanting to use this, yeah, then it's awesome. And it's fairly simple to install. I mean, that's obviously me and Garrett, I think, both showed videos how to do that. So you can go check that out if you haven't seen it and want to mess around with it. But, there was that. Have there been any other, like, I don't think there's been any other notable mods this past week, has there?
In terms of notable mods, not that I can think of. We had, like, the Sweet FX come out, like, last week, I think it was. We had the FOV mod. We've had nothing really crazy on beside the trainer. I mean, the trainer is a huge step in the right direction, though, if you think about it. I mean, it's something that I've always enjoyed in the game. And if you guys are confused what a trainer is, just for, if you guys are watching for the first time, not really sure what a trainer is. Basically, it's a program that allows you to do things that you should be able to do in GTA 5, like teleport
around
the map.
It's a mod menu.
Yeah, it's a menu. It's a menu that allows you to do different things. You can change your skin. You can give yourself all the weapons in the game. You can go ahead and teleport anywhere on the map.
It's like director mode, kind of, but it's what not director in director mode.
Yeah, it's what director mode should have been.
Yeah, that's pretty much actually. So it's really awesome, and again, it's only single player, so you're not gonna break or ruin anybody else's experience in online. So that's good. There's actually some controversy regarding the Field of View mod though in online, and if you guys care about this, let us know in the comment section. But people have been saying that there's obviously people on both sides of the fence. Like, one group of people are saying that the Field of View mod in online Like, his Rockstar's field of view slider, I think they said only goes up to either 55 or 65, which isn't
no,
that
it, it's
high.
85, isn't it?
Well, it's 55 or 65 horizontal. Anyway, it's some weird stuff. It's horizontal, which you had to, like, do some math. And then, yeah, it's around, like, 80, 85 regular. But a lot of PC guys want to play a lot higher than that. So, obviously, there's a mod to do it. And people just, you know, there's just this whole controversy as to whether or not it's, I say cheating. I mean, technically it's cheating because you're putting, you know, the files in there that they're not supposed to be. But, like, in terms of having an advantage, people were kind of up, you know, arguing about that. You have any opinions, Garrett?
I mean, Ross, you've seen the video that Austin did the other day, right? Where he had the field of view, like, where he could see so much more.
Yeah. Like, when we were playing Snipers and Stunters together, like, I was, I got to see his point of view. And it looks kind of like, it reminds me of Battlefield, kind of like how their arms look kind of rubbery because you're getting it from such a weird angle. But, I mean, it's cool. It does allow you to see a wider field of view as compared to just, like, the normal first person, which is really close up because normal first person, Rockstar's default, it's like the gun is really close, which is great because you get to see a lot of the gun details. But at the same time, first-person view is restricted, like it is in real life.
Do you think that's fair? Like, should that actually be there? Or
I think that this is getting really technical, but in like team death matches, yeah, you might want to cut that back. But like in free mode, if you're just walking around and want to have a wider field of view, like it shouldn't stop anyone. I don't have a problem with it.
Yeah, I think like
in online, it runs is that like you have an advantage over someone else because you can see them before they see you if they're in first person.
Yeah, I mean, look, there's pros and cons. Like, there's that, but then, you know, if you're looking straight in front of you, it kind of, you know, it's harder to see further away. And then you also got to take into account it's a third-person game, so, you know, you can easily go into third person and view all around you. I mean, so that, and this is kind of what I don't get. I get some people take GTA really seriously and make it competitive. It's not a competitive game though. And I mean, I've used it in online, obviously, as you saw from my video, and we still don't know what Rockstar's stance is on modding, which is kind of unfortunate because so many people want to know, you know, because there's this and there's even the texture mods like that make the game look a little bit better. And people want to know if they can use them online, and I guess we'll just have to wait and see what if they ever decide to come out and give a statement on modding. But yeah, as for the field of view mod, I think again, I don't want to say one way or another because I'm sure there's going to be people in the comment section that are going to disagree with whatever. But I understand both sides of the argument. But I mean that's all I had to say on that. Anything else you guys want to input?
No, I think that the whole FOV and the whole modding situation, there's always going to be a rift in the community, I think, where people are going to love it and hate it. And Rockstar, we know, already dislikes modding. But I think it's things like the trainer in single player that are cool. I like single player mods a lot. I like what we can do with single player. I want to have that ability to do whatever I want in single player. I want to have that freedom that, you know, we should have in a free roam game. But when it comes to online, then you draw that very strange line where it's like, this is wrong. Like an example, the other day I was playing GTA Online and there was someone as a monkey in my lobby. You know, like that's not normal. You're not supposed to be doing that. And eventually Rocks are probably going to lay down the ban hammer and we might have some ban waves coming in the near future. I don't know how they're going to be handling it, but we're going to have to wait and see. But what do you think, Ross? Like, where is your stance on modding as a whole?
I think that single player mods are fine. You're free to do it whatever you want with your game in single player. Obviously, it's not our game, but Rockstar's. But in single player, it's fine. You're not bothering anyone. And I think even the same can be said for Grand Theft Auto Online invite-only lobbies, where you just want to invite your friends. Like, if you want to be monkeys with your friends, go be monkeys with your friends. But in public lobbies where people can, like, bring a trainer in online and, you know, be a weird object in online with public lobbies and public players, I think that's where the line has to be drawn. I don't have a problem with you having fun with your friends because it's a game. You should have fun with your friends, but just restrict it to invite-only lobbies. I don't know where that line can be drawn. I highly doubt Rockstar is going to be like, oh, this is cool to use in invite-only lobbies, but the second you bring that into a public lobby, ban hammer. So we'll have to see.
And kind of going, moving from that to like the whole private servers, like there's two different ways that I could see mods in online or mods with friends like actually happening. The first way, and we can touch on this, is I brought up before with the whole Skyrim situation. Basically, if you guys aren't aware, Steam has made the Steam Workshop, like people basically, if they have a mod on the Steam Workshop for Skyrim, they can make money from it. And like what happens is 75% of the cut goes to Steam as well as, or to Valve and Bethesda, like it gets split, and then 25% goes to the modder. What if Rockstar did something like this where they allowed, like, I guess the modders to sort of work with the game, but then they would be taking, you know, a big chunk of that money? Do you
think
they
would have to support it, and they hate mods.
Well, yeah, yep. Obviously the support would have to be there, but you don't think anything like that would ever, like, you don't think Rockstar, if they could make money from it, they wouldn't? Or
I think it'd be too hard to manage on their end. Like, fair, I can enough see it working. Like, that's a really cool concept. GTA provides the perfect game for it. But Rockstar would really have to be passionate about liking mods. And they're already so hesitant to even allow it in single player that it would be like, you just never know.
Yeah, I don't know how they would react to it, to be honest with you. I think they'd be very, very upset, I think.
Well, but yeah, but what I'm saying is, like, if they could make money off of the mods, like, because obviously we know this by now. Rockstar, they want people to buy their shark cards so they can make money. It's a business, you know. We get that, and we're not gonna hate them for it. But like, what I'm saying is, maybe they might change their stance on mods if they could make money from the mods. You don't think that would ever happen?
I don't know.
Tough. Just monetizing mods.
Are you speaking of the brand new thing that Steam's doing with the whole?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking
like,
about.
Like, I think what Steam's doing is very, very weird.
Look, it's not right. I don't agree with it, but I'm just saying that's a possibility.
I just can't see Rockstar, like,
wouldn't that mean that you'd have to pay for the mod to get it in the game?
Yeah, you would. It's It'd really be like dumb a DLC. Because yeah, it the. I don't want to get into that too much, but it's the modders themselves are getting kind of screwed out of that. But I mean, I don't know. That's one possible way that could potentially make Rockstar change their mind if they were to monetize the mods. But I don't know. I guess you guys don't really think that will ever happen, do you?
No, I don't. I mean, Rockstar had the ability to do so much stuff with GTA 4 and the modding and stuff that was going on over there, and they never really did anything about it.
All right. Well, then the second way, and this is what you brought up earlier, would be the private servers. Like, there's a few different modding teams out there that are trying to get these dedicated servers, these third-party, this third-party software to run GTA Online and like, different versions, where one, you could have a role-playing server, or one, you could just have an invite-only private server for yourself. And like Ross said, you can be monkeys with your friends if you wanted to. And I think that'll probably be the more realistic way. Now, haven't you brought up Garrett? Don't you think Rockstar might like go after these people?
It's the Minecraft situation. You probably have more knowledge on this, Garrett, on what happened with Minecraft servers months ago.
Well, Minecraft, what happened is that Mojang owns Minecraft. They did. And once they started to, you know, get in the works of selling to Microsoft, they realized, oh my God, we have all these people making money off our game, and in our terms of service, it says that's not allowed, but we've been allowing it for all these years. So they went ahead and said, hey, by the way, if you're making money off our game, you're going to have to stop, or we're going to go after you. Nothing really ended up coming from it. They never really went after people. They never really, you know, did any of that stuff. But servers did make some changes so that they couldn't monetize 100% off their game. You know, now I think right now in Minecraft, a lot of servers are only selling cosmetic items where you can get, like, you know, different hats and different color text in game, but nothing really that, you know, makes you stronger or better than the other person when it came to the mods and different servers and kits you could buy. So I don't know. If Rockstar were to go down that path of, like, I don't know what Rockstar's rules are. Most companies have it that you can't make money off someone else's product, because it's just, that's not legal. It just doesn't make sense. It's like someone re-uploading our videos on YouTube and just like monetizing them, or like, it doesn't make sense. So Rockstar, And I know what they've done in the past to people on Xbox 360, Xbox One, PS4, and PS3 that were modders and just looked inside code. You know, they went after them and filed for cease and desists and sent lawyers their way and stuff like that. So I don't know. It's gonna be weird. I honestly think they might take like the World of Warcraft approach, what Blizzard did. Basically, any private server that ever goes up that's not owned by Blizzard of World of Warcraft, they instantly get shut down and a huge lawsuit is brought down. So that's probably what Rockstar's going to do. They're going to strong arm everyone into only playing GTA 5 online because this is their baby. This is their cash cow. This is what's going to take Rockstar through the future. I mean, they're just going to keep making money off GTA 5 online. And with the money they make off GTA 5 online, be allowed to pay for their staff, be allowed to pay for extra DLCs to make new games, make different, you know, bullies or more GTA series.
I'm sorry, the $800 million we made from GTA 5 on day one is just not just.
Hey man, you gotta keep the investors happy. Enough is never enough.
I'm like so happy.
How else you guys think they're gonna keep those cloud servers going down?
You know, each cloud they have in that sky is thousands of dollars, so they gotta make sure that all of them stay up. If not, then they're all gonna start falling down. We'll have no clouds when we're up there. So overall, I think Rockstar's gonna strong arm them.
I was about to say, random fact of the day, GTA 5 broke 7 Guinness Book of World Records within the first 24 hours.
Just like the size of my dick.
Excuse me? Excuse me. But, yeah, man, it's going to be a battle. And, you get into this sort of debate on what's better. Less people playing GTA Online, but, you know, say purchasing shark cards, or a lot more people playing GTA Online for longer, but them not making as much money. You know, that's kind of like, do you want the money? Like, as a business, would you want the money for a shorter period of time, or do you want people to be playing your game for a longer period of time, not making as much money? That's kind of in the situation we're in, and it's gonna be interesting because nothing like this has ever been done. Really, like you can equate it to Minecraft, but yeah, exactly, nothing's been done with that. You can equate it to, I guess, Arma, and I guess the people who make Arma, they're fine with all the mods and servers and stuff being up, so they haven't done anything. But Rockstar's like one of the biggest companies, you know, like it's gonna be good to see. Good for who? That's yet to be determined. But
stay tuned.
I don't know. Yeah. Any final thoughts on the whole like private server stuff?
I don't think they're gonna be coming very soon. We're just have to wait and see. But besides that, I do know.
I want to mention this real quick. One of the teams, I don't know who, but one of the teams that are trying to make a private server system for GTA Online, they made this system, or they made a third party, online system for Modern Warfare 2 way back in the day called AlterIW.net or something like that. And a lot of people played on it. Now, eventually, they did get, I think, a cease and desist form from Activision, but I think they just ignored it. So, and it's still, I don't know if it's still up today.
I don't recommend.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you shouldn't do that. But I'm just saying,
if you ever find yourself in a situation where you received one of those,
it's scary, dude. But
it's, I mean, if maybe they might have the same approach to this, but it's I just hope everything turns out, you know, and everybody's happy, you know, like that. Ideally, Rockstar still gets their money and we get to play some awesome mods with our friends.
Be monkeys.
That's all I want. Because like having a Battle Royale server or like a Hunger Games server or something in GTA, it'd be awesome. But who knows? Maybe they'll go the H1Z1 route and partner up with like the Battle Royale people or something, you know, and make it an actual like an official game mode. That'd be something. But yeah, like Ross said, we'll have to wait and see. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned, boys. Stay tuned. Man.
But I guess you guys we're gonna hop into the next topic, the social club stuff. Yeah. I don't know much about this, but
Ross knows. Ross, yeah.
Okay, so there's actually been a lot of reports. I think the number was close to like 2,500 accounts had been hacked where they had lost the ability to log into Social Club. And it wasn't per se that the Social Club was actually hacked, but you know on like Twitter, how you can authorize like third-party sites to access your Twitter to like post a tweet for you or to look into some information. Well, those got hacked. And so Rockstar, I don't think they've officially addressed this that I know of, but they
They have made it. Well, I don't think they've addressed it, but they did make it to where you can't change your email at all, or you can't change your password at all right now, or so, like something.
Okay, so they're in kind of like damage control mode until they figure this out. So, yeah, the recommendation was to change your password, but if you can't change your password, just keep an eye out. And the social club has a pretty big fault, and it's got like no security checks. It's literally if you get in, you're screwed because there's no two-step or three-step verification. So, and it's crazy because I know that I have my Xbox, my Facebook, my Twitter, my PS4 all connected to that. So if someone got that, that would be bad news.
Yeah, well
I mean, just spending $60, you know, I mean, Ross kind of knows.
I know, seriously. I'm well aware.
But,
of
you know, like, that's, yeah, that does kind of suck. And apparently, like, I've just been reading on the forums and on various news sites, apparently Rockstar support hasn't been too helpful.
Yeah, I saw the video, like they hung up on someone, which
I hate
articles like that, and I hate videos where a very disgruntled fan like calls and wants their way, and when they don't get their way, they make a video like that because obviously it makes the company look bad. But I don't know. I did see that.
Another one was apparently they offered somebody a free T-shirt. In exchange for his lost GTA copy.
I saw a really funny post today. I think this was on the GTA Reddit where someone had lost like $4 million worth of cars and Rockstar said they would refund him $4 million, but they gave him 4 million RP and he went from a level 42 to 178 or something like that.
That is pretty funny. I can just imagine. And then he messaged him back. He's like, listen, I'm sorry. You gave me 4 million RP. Can I get reset to level 44
and
get the money back? It's pretty funny, though. But yeah, man, it's been a mess, apparently. But
we'll see.
I don't know.
We will see how Rockstar handles
this.
Yeah, because I know what really happened. I think they mentioned in our Kotaku article that the third-party salespeople, basically how hackers work. There's databases out there that have been hacked, they've been cracked. And let's say, you know, a website you signed up to a long time ago, let's say it's, I don't know, let's pretend it's a, I don't know, give me an example of a website that you guys are signed up to.
GTAUniverse.com.
Okay, yeah. We're not going to use that as an example because that place is not getting anybody's information leaked. But let's say you have an account on some kind of porn site or something, right? And a hacker decides that he gets all users. Twitch, perfect. Let's go ahead and discredit that porn example I was going to use. Twitch got hacked a while ago, and usernames and passwords are leaked. If you guys remember, you had to change your passwords a while ago because users got into the database and were able to see usernames and passwords. Well, what ended up happening is that when that happens, a lot of users use the same username and password for a lot of websites. And what hackers are doing, they're going through the social club and seeing what usernames and passwords work on the social club. And in turn, they are getting a bunch of GTA 5 PC copies. So that's how it works. And I just went on a huge rant about porn
and
hacking.
And,
yeah, so that's pretty much exactly what happened. But let's go ahead and move on from this because social club isn't really hacked. Just change your passwords and I think you guys should be fine. But without further ado, let's get into some Black Ops 3 leaked information.
There was a lot
okay,
today,
so
it was actually good.
There was. Yeah. Did you actually, you saw it, right, Ross?
Yes, I've seen all the
leaks. I actually have it pulled up. I don't know. I think, what, this Sunday is actually, or yeah, tomorrow's
yes, tomorrow, when you guys are watching this, tomorrow is the official reveal for Black Ops 3.
Yeah, and then, and unfortunately, on Friday, there was some leakage going on.
A ton of leakage. Like, not even like a leak, like the pipe burst and all the, pretty much a lot came out.
Yeah, one positive thing that, I mean, at least I think is a positive thing, they're actually going to have a beta for this, which is the first time since, I think, what, World at War or, like, Call of Duty 4?
That's
going
to be really cool. Leave it to Treyarch to be awesome and actually do a beta for Call of Duty.
Yeah, and I think you just get the beta, you get beta access by, like, just pre-ordering, which, I mean, everybody pre-orders Call of Duty anyway, so, you know, that's pretty cool. But this has been the controversial thing of Call of Duty the past year. The movement and, unfortunately, for people who do not like, I guess, exosuits, they had this, screenshot of the back of a the.
It
They're like built the box in exosuits. So like Advanced Warfare was like you put the suit on. This time they're like genetically engineered into you.
Yeah. Well, basically, I'm reading from the thing. It says, with Black Ops 3, Treyarch premieres a new momentum-based chained movement system, allowing players to fluidly move through the environment with finesse using controlled thrust jumps, slides, and mantling abilities in a multitude of combinations. So definitely sounds similar to Exo
yeah,
suits.
Yeah, I think it's their version of the Exos. Like I said, it's just not a suit. We'll have to see, though. They also had the release date, which was November 6th, which I don't have a calendar pull up. I don't know what November 6th is. I imagine it's a Tuesday.
It's probably a Tuesday. It's actually interesting, though, because I think, yeah, it actually, it feels earlier, but Battlefront comes out November 17th, I think. So normally like the EA and Battlefield games come out in October before Call of Duty. So it's going to be interesting to see like sort of what happens to that. But yeah, man, it's, I don't know. My hype has kind of died down a little bit.
I'm still excited.
Has yours? Are you?
I'm so excited.
Yeah, Garrett?
I can tell you put a lot of input.
I actually have no idea what's going on, but hey, Mom!
Well, did you see the trailer that was, not a trailer, but it was like the embers?
The trailer looked awesome. Nope. Yeah, the teaser looked pretty cool. I get Treyarch does make some cool, like I'll probably play it for single player. And Treyarch games
and
are awesome.
And zombies, you can't forget that.
Yeah, oh, zombies is going to be great too. I don't know if I'm that excited about multiplayer. We'll have to wait and see though, I guess, tomorrow when they have the official sort of release for it. But final thoughts on that, I guess, and then we can move on to
Big Pipe.
It's Call of Duty. Comes out every year, but this time it's Treyarch. We haven't seen them for 3 years, and it has the potential to be awesome. We'll see. Like I said, yeah. I'm not getting my hopes up because when you keep your expectations low, you can all things can only be good, which is a good way to.
That's kind of what I'm
by.
Doing.
Yeah. Not saying you want to be a pet. Okay, yeah, we can move on.
Sorry.
Life advice
so
with the squad.
Moving on into SpeakPipe, we have a few here. The first one we have is from Robert.
Robert.
What's going on, guys? Squad. What's going on, guys? Squad. I have a question that I've been wondering about a lot, and this is just whether, like, if there was a potential story mode DLC coming out, normally Rockstar, like, puts a separate online, like in GTA 4, with the Bald Gay Tony, had a separate online, and those people couldn't play with the GTA 4 people. Like, it was two separate, like, online, I guess. So I wonder if GTA 5, that would work. Like, if they had a separate DLC, would it be two separate GTA 5 online? As well as, like, would people have to restart their level? Like, that would be pretty awful, if you ask me. And, yeah. Thanks for using my question, and have a good day.
Robert!
It's a good question. Good question. Definitely a concern for a lot of people. I don't think so. One, because GTA 4's multiplayer was never like the extent of Grand Theft Auto Online, which is a separate entity and a separate world. It was kind of weird that they made you separate. And I think the reason behind that was different weapons and guns. And for whatever reason, you couldn't be in a lobby where someone had different vehicles and someone had different guns than someone else. But in Grand Theft Auto Online, whenever they make a story mode DLC, I'll imagine those story mode DLC vehicles will just come to Grand Theft Auto Online, so there won't be an issue.
Or they'll be exclusive to just story mode. Like
right,
done
and then you won't have to deal with it, which is, that would answer that question.
Yeah. The only kind of thing that, I mean, one, I don't think, like, yeah, we're not going to ever have to restart our characters. That's just not going to make sense. The only thing I can see potentially making different lobbies is if they were to ever do some sort of Las Venturas or San Fierro DLC.
That would be hyped. That would be,
you know,
so
what
hyped.
I mean?
Oh, come on,
yeah,
pants.
You'd have some like loading screen or something. But yeah, that's probably the only thing. And is that going to happen? Probably not.
If we see
yeah,
like 3 months from now,
it.
We see on the newswire like "Welcome to Las Venturas," and it's just got that rock star link. I'll scream like a girl and I'll run outside, and it'll be great. That's literally all my neighbors are going to be like. What is this? What's going on?
What's going on over here?
But anyway, yeah, that'd be so cool. Gosh.
Alrighty, so moving on to the next question, we have Zach.
Hey Dawson, I just wanted to ask you, would you guys rather want a story mode DLC, whether that carries on the story of Franklin, Trevor, and Michael, or a new story mode between, like, Lamar, or an outsider character? Or would you rather want a casino DLC, as well as an additional stock market and lottery system in Grand Theft Auto Online? Love this podcast. Keep it up.
All right, real quick, let's just subtract the casino.
Can I have
all
the above?
It's actually an interesting debate on the single player DLC. Would you rather continue the stories or like go to like Lamar
Rockstar
or a side character?
Didn't Rockstar say they were going to continue the story? They said like in 2014.
Yeah, if you could do,
I think
you could have the DLC.
Funny enough, where he could have his own DLC. He's that much of a character.
Yeah,
but
I kind of am with you
the
there.
The game pretty much sets it up perfectly to have like a pro prologue where you like play as young Michael and Trevor and they're like North Yankton and bank robbery days.
That could be cool because then that could like incorporate
and
more
you,
heists or whatever.
Right. Yeah. You could have like a couple North Yankton heists and then the final mission might be like the prep leading up to their little bank heist we saw in the beginning or I don't know, something like that.
Yeah, I agree. Garrett?
I want all of the above. And I think it would be better to just, I don't know. I want to see, like, I've mentioned in the past, I want to see their past, like, what they were doing, like, before. Like, a flashback of, like, Franklin's mm-hmm. gangsta life before he tried, like, being such a good guy. I don't know.
Yeah,
that would actually be really cool. Rockstar, for
like,
listening.
Basically, like, a look at Michael, what he was doing when he was, like, in retirement. A look at Trevor, how he was, like, starting up TPI. Yeah, and like when he didn't have Michael around and how his life was, and then look at Franklin's life when you know before he met Michael and stuff.
So not like a pre-prologue, but like a in between
Mid,
the prologue
yeah, in between.
And
yeah,
in between
yeah.
the start of the actual game when Michael's mm-hmm, in mm-hmm. Freelander's office. Gotcha. That'd
yeah,
be
yeah,
super
be awesome.
Cool.
Yep. Because I have the best ideas.
Finally,
so.
Okay, all right.
Rockstar, if you're listening,
finally the last
just hit left gold.
The last sort of question here, not really a question. This is for Gary.
City of Seattle, not Tennessee. Gear Bear, living by the sea, playing GTA on PC. Gear Bear, living a life, playing GTA all the time. Gear Bear, I don't know if he likes to share.
I'm gonna have that as my intro. That is great, dude.
Oh man!
Oh god!
The things we get.
That
things
was
you guys
great.
Sent
that
us,
was
man.
Awesome. Hey, who was that? Did you leave a name?
That was Zachary. Yeah,
Zachary. That was awesome.
Zachary, you've got a career in the kids song business.
That was awesome. That was so awesome. All right. Well, anything else you want to say before we do wrap this up?
I do believe that is it.
Yeah, all right, guys. Make sure you guys check out facebook.com/utechsmart to go ahead and enter into the giveaway. Thank you guys so much for all the support, watching all the way to the end. And we'll see you guys next week with another Squadcast or tomorrow with our daily uploads. Later, guys.
Later.
Peace.
Bye.